runs in this ball game. Got a run in the first, a run in the third. The run in the third was a home run by John Sheshick. For the senior from Houston Dolby, it was his 10th home run of the season. It'll be 8-9-1 in the A&M batting order. In the top of the fourth inning, Mike Proto is a left-hander working for the Clemson Tigers. Aggies have out hit Clemson 5-3 after three innings. First pitch to Screech is a called strike. He singles in the second inning, stole second, went to third on a wild pitch. We stranded him right there. We've left five runners in the first three innings. Scarborough waits. There's another strike at strike two. Hudson is on deck. Truett will be the third man in the inning. Be checking other scores as we get the opportunity. 0-2 pitch is low. That's a ball. It's one ball and two strikes. They've still got a right-hander.
That's still Addison
down there. Addison down in the bullpen. So we'll continue to watch him.
They have to have somebody ready, and it'd be the same thing with the Aggies if Ward starts to show any signs, because you don't have any reason to save anybody.
One ball, two strikes. Scarborough waits, lifts it high in the air into right center field. Holstad's going over, shading his eyes from the sun, and makes a running catch. Wasn't running real hard. It was a light jog. It's an out into right field. It's three times that we have flied to right in this ballgame.
And that's five fly ball outs. They did a good job in the first inning of keeping the ball down. There were no fly outs in the first inning, but since then they've had five of the next seven outs have been in the air.
At the plate, Hudson, a strike on the first pitch. You can hear it in the background. 0-1, outside for the ball. One ball, no strikes. One ball, one strike, make it on Hudson. Hudson fouled out to the first baseman. His last at bat, got a base hit. Sharply hit ground ball between first and second into right field. That's gonna be his sixth hit in 10 at-bats against Clemson this weekend.
And wouldn't you give a dollar to change that one for the time he was up before with the runner on third?
Tell you something else that he's just done. Just got himself a base hit against the left-handed pitcher. I like the way Chad's been playing. I know he's made some, had some situations where he wanted to deliver and didn't get the base hit. But, and you go back to the opening ball game, he went 4-for-5. On Friday night, had four RBI in that ballgame with a home run.
He has answered the problem in left field. It was the first part of the season. Mark didn't know what to do, and Hudson's clearly taken that job and done a good job.
Going to throw again over to first base, pretty close there. It's,
it's also pretty close to a balk move, because Proto came pretty close to crossing that imaginary line where you step more towards the plate than you do first base.
Standing at the plate, Truett waiting on a first pitch. They've thrown twice over to first base, trying to keep Hudson close. First pitch to Steven. Up high and away for a ball. One ball, no strikes on Truett, who has doubled and walked in the ball game.
Of course, Chad Hudson, bless his heart, he and Dalen are the two most, how shall we say it, adventurous base runners the Aggies have.
1-0. Again, they're going to throw over to first base. Harris standing there.
Once again, he is very close to balking, because he's coming awfully close to stepping more towards the plate than he does to first. I wouldn't be surprised if there was some chirping out the Aggie dugout about that.
Straight away, deep in the outfield on their defense. First baseman's on the sack. Rest of the defense is back on the infield. Strike called on Truett. Truett's double is 23rd of the season. The run scored was his 78th of the year. Truett hit 307 in 97, 304 last year, 345 coming into the ball game today. Boy, they are working on Hudson, first base. 6-for-9 in stolen bases. Trying to keep him as close as possible. Apparently feeling they got a tough out here at the plate in Truett, who got that double at the base of the fence in his first at bat to lead off the ball game in the first. He comes in tight there, and Truett started to offer and then thinks better of it. Truett has 27 multi-hit games this year. He has now hit safely in 53 of the games in which he has appeared. And that total is now to 65. Once more, they'll throw to first base. Maybe they'll throw it away. Our ball game is 2-0. It's the top of the fourth. The Aggies leading Clemson. A&M's got a runner at first base with one out. Hudson is the runner. Truitt's at the plate. Swing and a miss. Oh, he had a rip. That might have been a high fastball. Could have been out of the strike zone.
A little bit extra giddy up on that one from Proto, and he needed it because he got it up in the strike zone, and Stephen Truitt liked what he saw but couldn't quite catch up with that high fastball.
Two balls, two strikes. Proto looks in. Ellis gives him a sign. And a small lead over at first base by Hudson. How many times, Larry, they've gone in that direction?
Well, I'm going to count pitches for you today, but I'm not going to count throws to first.
He's got about five throws over there, maybe six. 2-2 on Truitt. He's still waiting. And now Proto works to the plate outside a full count. He walked on a 3-1 pitch in the second inning.
You better get ready for some more throws to first because they'll expect the Aggies to start the runner as I do, and so they'll try to see if they can get Hudson leaning here. The key for Hudson is he's got to make sure he's going to the plate.
He's got a little bit bigger lead this time than he did last time, and they got him breaking. They got him in a rundown between short and first. They've gone back to the shortstop, and the shortstop, did he miss the tag? I think he missed the tag. Now Hudson's going to second base. But they say, no, he tagged him and he went down. That's well, they picked him at first base.
Exactly what I said. You have to make sure he's going to go.
So that goes from 1-3-6 on the pickoff. Runners erased. Got a 3-2 on Truitt. Larry just said that he got to make sure he's coming to the plate. And he wasn't. Hudson broke, and they threw back at first base, threw behind him. There's a ball. So the second walk to Stephen Truitt. Walked back in the second inning. With two outs, he's now at first base. Aggies now have walked 16 times against Clemson pitching.
You just wonder if later on this afternoon we'll look back at some of these missed opportunities and say they were the deciding factor.
Here we go. Sean Heaney 0 for 2. And the pitch is skied over the infield. Out behind second base. The catch will be made and they're out of the inning. So we strand a man at first base. Had a fly ball to right. Single to Hudson. Picked off trying to go to second base. And then Heaney flies out. On the infield on the very first pitch. So the ball game now. We'll move to the bottom of the fourth inning, and it's 2-0, A&M leading Clemson. Winner goes to Omaha. Hope it's the Aggies. Clemson coming to the plate here in the bottom of the fourth with Boyd, Boltman, and Harris. This is Aggie baseball. Boyd will lead off for Clemson in the bottom of the fourth. Texas A&M has a 2-0 lead. Matt Ward has given up three hits. He struck out three. He's gotten a couple of double play balls behind him today. Boyd, the first pitch of ball, the second in for a called strike. Boyd hit into the double play back in the first inning after Stanley started the bottom of the first with a single. All three of their hits have been one base hits. 1-1 to Boyd. Right at the outside corner, didn't do it. Two balls and one strike. Matt Ward now for the year with these three strikeouts in the ball game today with 59 strikeouts. left-hander out of Irvine, California. A line drive into the gap into left center. Truitt got over in a hurry. Boyd, a wide turn at first base. They'll hold him to a single. Truitt got there in a hurry. Boyd is held to one. The second time of the ball game that their lead man has reached. They got a leadoff single by Stanley back in the first. Here is Bultman. Bultman, a fly ball his last time out to Dalen Holt in right field. Baylor and Oklahoma State, even at a game apiece. Jason Jennings had a three-run homer, and Brian Loeb added a two-run shot in the sixth inning as Baylor pulled away 17-7 last night in Waco. They're playing the third and final game of that Super Regional today. First pitch to Bultman is high for a ball. And our last report on that ball game had Baylor leading 1-0 in the bottom of the seventh inning. Reminiscent of the Oklahoma State game that they played against, I guess it was Nebraska, wasn't it? In the opening game of the Big 12 tournament when they had just, I think, just one or two hits and shut out. Maybe it was a one-hitter thrown by Nebraska. OSU's run into a good pitching job today. Here's a ball lifted high into right center field. Truitt's coming over, calling off Holt. Holt drops back. Truitt steps in front of him and makes the catch. That's the first out of the bottom of the fourth inning. Boyd stays at first. He had a single. He's there. Jason Harris grounded out his last time 4-3. Let's see if he can get another double play. Aggies have turned two today for 69 now on the season. Clemson has hit into 64 for the year. First time that these two have played baseball. Mentioned earlier, we had a home-and-home series with them in basketball. It was just completed within the last 3 or 4 years. Made our way over the first game to Clemson, South Carolina. They made the return visit. I don't know if that was last year or year before. I can't remember without looking at the schedule. Jason Harris standing at the plate as Ward worked over to first base. Works over there again with Sheshick standing on the back. Straight away and deep in the outfield. On the left-handed hitting first baseman, Jason Harris. Struck out three times against the Aggies this weekend. He's now 1-for-9 at the plate, outside for a ball. Ball one. Have a change on the Baylor-Oklahoma State game. Top of the eighth, Baylor 2. Oklahoma State nothing. Top of the eighth inning. Baylor inching closer to the College World Series. And again, Ward works over to first base. Baylor has not been to the College World Series since the 1978 season. OSU, of course, has multiple appearances in the CWS. They were there the last time that the Aggies were there, back in 93. A 1-0 pitch coming to the plate. Fouls it back. One ball, one strike on Jason Harris. 2-0, the Aggies with the lead, bottom of the fourth over Clemson.
You hear that score, and it makes you wonder who's pitching today for Baylor to be throwing a shutout that deep into the game on a Sunday. That's pretty stout.
Especially the two games they have played. Oklahoma State won the first one 18-11. Baylor won the second one 17-7. Now it's 2-0 on the top of the eighth, time called. And they have just got Ward for a balk. Here comes Mark Johnson out to talk to Gus Rodriguez. They have balked Boyd down to second base. Mark comes out to have a visit. Jimmy Lawler is talking to the second base umpire, and I think he's just said that not Rodriguez called it. Scott Graham, the second base umpire, when Lawler said something to him, pointed toward home plate. One ball, one strike, one out. Runner now at second base. Time called as Schumacher will go out and say something to Matt Ward. Looking at box for the year, and that will be the very first called against Matt Ward. Fossum has been whistled three times, if you will, on box. And I think that's the sixth time we've been called for a balk. Our opponents have balked nine times this season. Let's see what happens. One ball, one strike, one out. Runner now at second base. Left-handed hitting Jason Harris at the plate. There's a called strike. Strike two. One and two. Struck out the last two men he faced in the second. Got a lead strikeout in the third. Two of the three strikeouts have been a caught-looking situation. Ward again ready to work. The left-hander coming to the plate out of the stretch. Misses outside. It's a ball. Top of the ninth inning, Cal State Fullerton 13, Ohio State 2. Cal State Fullerton looks like they're on their way to Omaha. 2-2. Boyd dancing off at second. Ward works to Harris. Here's a line drive. It's Scarborough. He'll go to the bag and double Boyd off. Scarborough caught a line drive off the bat of Harris. Boyd had a break. He was trying to get back. Scarborough won the race. Boyd's out six unassisted. Harris lines to six for the second out. Boyd is the third out. A runner at second and another double play. The Aggies have turned three double plays in four innings. The fifth is coming up. Your Aggies lead Clemson 2-0. This is Aggie baseball. Number five, Dalen Holt, followed by John Sheshick, and then Eric Solbach for Texas A&M. The Aggies lead 2-0 into the fifth inning. Clemson the opponent, Super Regional Sunday. Series not into the game apiece. Mike Frodo is working for the Tigers today. He's a left-hander. And Dalen hits one into left field. It's going to be playable. On the first pitch, skies it. Stone will make it well shy of the warning track on the catch. He is 0-for-3 with an RBI, Holt. Grounded out for an RBI on the first inning. Fly to right, now fly to left. John Sheshick, a home run his last time over the fence and left. Hit just a few feet to the left of the right field foul pole. Got some kind of a shift on here. We're looking at their second baseman. He's shifted way over toward first. First pitch to Shesh is in for a strike call. Right fielder's pretty much norm out there, and there is a big gap. The center fielder drifting over toward right center, big gap in the left center. Strike two called on Sheshick. Hit by the pitch in the first inning. We left him at second base. Got a one-out solo home run in the third. Was his 10th home run of the season. Shesh is waiting. Holtz made an out, flying out to left field. That pitch misses away, got away from the catcher, Ellis. It's one ball and two strikes. Some of the fans asking Gus Rodriguez why he didn't call that a strike. They love to ride the home plate umpire. 10 home runs and now 53 RBI for John Sheshick, and this is senior season. He's walked 56 times this year. Ground ball at short, backhanded there by LaCroix. Throw in time at first base. Two men are down, and here is Eric Sobek. Mentioned a moment ago that Cal State Fullerton is ahead of Ohio State 13-2 in the top of the ninth. Looks like they're going to qualify for the College World Series. I was looking through the record book today. Solbeck is going to take some time here to go back to the on-deck circle and get the pine tar cloth. Those are two quick outs, and they want a little more rest time on the bench for Ward. But Cal State Fullerton, Larry, in the 1990s, is the winningest program in the country. And I'll give you some figures on that in just a moment. Solbeck is waiting on a first pitch. He singled his first time, fly to center his last. Chopped at second baseman, Boltman. On the downward flight of a chopped ground ball. Gets it, goes to first, and we go three up and three down. For the first time in the game today, that's the fifth inning. The top of the fifth, and now the bottom of number five coming up. Again, A&M lost the coin toss on Thursday. Clemson, the home team last night. The coin toss allows them to be the home team here on this Sunday afternoon. 2-0, A&M over Clemson. This is Aggie baseball.
Michael Collins, OSU.
The story of the ball game for Texas A&M has come here in the first four innings. They have turned in three double plays. Matt Ward needs that kind of defense behind him. He's given up four hits today. The Aggies lead 2-0. Here's a ground ball knocked down by Scarborough. Gets up. Here's a long throw. Got him at first base and hopped into Sheshick. What a play by Scarborough. And when he went down and stopped it, it was a hard fall. And then he got up, threw it as hard as he could, one hop to Shesh, somewhat toward the right field side of the bag. And Khalil Green on the first pitch is an out on an outstanding play by Scarborough.
He's got a great arm. That's one of the things that Screech has always been able to do. And when he got that ball, most shortstops would not have been able to make the play even after stopping it, but he has such a strong arm that he was able to get it over there just in time.
Here's Holstad. He swings and misses at the first pitch. Green leads off the bottom of the fifth. Hit it in the hole. Scarborough, not only the arm on that one, Larry, but I mean the way he went hard to the ground and stopping that ball. Did a big old belly flop and got up and still made the throw. See, one ball, one strike. So an out and nobody on to start the bottom of the fifth for the Tigers. I'd like to say that's routine for Scarborough, and that throw obviously is, and he has made play after play like that this season. Call strike on the next pitch to Holstad. I really like Steve Scarborough.
Well, those type of plays are the plays that get you over the hump and get you to Omaha.
Back deep on the infield. Truett shifted toward right center out in center field. There's a call strike three. Oh, that's the second time Holstad is out on strikes. That's four in the ball game. For Ward, two outs in the bottom of the fifth inning. Brian Ellis struck out his last time on a 2-2 pitch. Just need us to get us some more runs here. We're ahead 2-0 with two outs in the bottom of the fifth inning. Aggie scored a run in the first and a run in the third. The run in the third was a home run. For A&M, it was the 125th home run of the season. First pitch down and low for a ball. Cal State Fullerton is the winningest program in the 1990s. They've got 434 wins, 175 losses in the 1990s. Here's the next pitch to Ellis on a 1-0. Lifts this one high into left center field. Hudson's calling Truett off. Coming in, gloves it for the out. I'll finish this winning thing for the 90s when we come back. Three up and three down in the bottom of the fifth for Clemson. Played five, going to six. A&M is ahead 2-0 in this game. Winner goes to Omaha in the College World Series. This is Aggie Baseball. The Cal State Fullerton is the winningest program in the 1990s. 434 and 175. And guess who the second winningest program is in the 1990s? Well, if you look out here at the maroon and white team playing on this field on this Sunday afternoon, it's Texas A&M. The Aggies, including what they've done this season, got them down at 429 and 194. That's the second winningest program, A&M. In the 90s, only behind Cal State Fullerton. Hopefully, we're going to see Cal State Fullerton and A&M playing in the College World Series here in 99. 6-7 tonight, Schumacher, Lindsey, and Scarborough in the top of the sixth. Proto misses high upstairs over the helmet of Schumacher. He went 3-1 in the first inning, doubled. We left him out at second base in the third. Left-hander against left-hander. One out of the Aggie catcher. Low and away for a ball. That's ball two. So we can't just break it open right here and get a big old bushel basket full of runs. 2-0. Left-hander Proto works again. Take one into the gap. Looks like Stone may have a play on that. Reaches up on the run near the warning track. Now as he catches the ball, he runs onto the track. Out number one. So he had him played nicely out in left field. Over into left center. Stone made the catch. One man down. Here's Del Lindsay. He's lined to the shortstop. He's grounded out to second base. 0 for 2. Now 3 for 9 this weekend against Clemson. Hits from the right side. Scarborough is on deck. First pitch to the Aggie third baseman. Swings and misses and a strike. Del Lindsay hitting 311 at the start of the ball game today. He was hitting 308 on Friday night at the beginning of play in that one. An 0-1 pitch. Here's a strike call. Looked a little bit low from here, but home plate umpire Gus Rodriguez gave it a strike. Final now. Cal State Fullerton beats Ohio State 13-2. They take that series 2 out of 3. He's blooped one into left field. Stone running. Good speed makes the catch. Two outs to left field to start the sixth inning. Here is Scarborough, and he'll take time again. He'll walk back and hand the bat here to one of the Diamond Darlings. Now he's taking his own good time about getting into the batter's box, trying to give Matt Ward some time here. We went 3 up and 3 down on the fifth. Proto now has retired 6 Aggies in a row. Scarborough waits. The left-hander delivers. That's a fastball strike at the letters. 0-1 on Scarborough. He singled, stole second, wild pitch to third, left him at third in the second inning. Fly ball his last time to right field. Back deep on the infield, straight away, and pretty deep in the outfields. Lifted one into left field. Here's Stone over near the warning track. Now Boyd coming over on the run on the warning track at the 375 mark. Makes the catch, calling Stone off. 3 to the outfield in the top of the sixth. Proto's retired 7 in a row as we go to the bottom of the sixth inning. It will be 8-9-1 in the batting order for the Tigers. Aggies lead Clemson 2-0. This is Aggie baseball. By Casey Stone, and then the top of the order, Henri Stanley. The bottom of the sixth inning, it's 2-0. The Aggies lead Clemson. Matt Ward back out on the hill. He got him 3 up and 3 down in the fifth inning, including a strikeout looking of Holland for the second time. On the net in front of us, a strike on LaCroix. LaCroix caught looking at a 1-2 pitch in the third. Got a little string of his own going here. He has faced the minimum now in the last three innings with the help of a couple of double plays. He has retired 5 in a row. The last man to reach base was a single. That was the lead man in the fourth inning. Fouled off up on top to the right side. Top of the fifth, Rice 2, Southwestern Louisiana nothing. Oh, top of the eighth, Baylor 2, Oklahoma State 2. Came back and tied it, so that shutout is gone in Waco. Cowboys not going quietly inside with that pitch. It's 1-2, so they've tied it in the top of the eighth inning. OSU 2, Baylor 2. I guess that star right here means that they are the home team. Baylor's the home team in that ball game. USL's the home team in the dome. Next pitch. Where was that? Down low, apparently. It's two balls, two strikes. LaCroix, 3 of 8. Now 3 of 9 this weekend against the Aggies. Matt Ward, 2-2 pitch. Ground ball, that's just foul outside of third. There, head coach Jack Leggett trying to convince the third base umpire, Larry Randall, that was fair. So we'll hold it 2-2. Two balls, two strikes. So Cal State Fullerton has joined Stanford, Florida State, Alabama, and Miami qualifying for the 99 College World Series. 2-2 pitch. Reaches out, punches one down the right field line. Foul ball. Oh, it was close. Trying to punch his way on. He misses by a matter of about 2 feet. That's extra bases. See if that thing hits fair.
Where do you play him now? He missed a foul ball on the left field line by about a foot, and about a foot on the right field line. Where do you play him?
Pretty much straight away in the outfield. LaCroix, 3 home runs, 42 RBI, has 2 this weekend against the Aggies. Has 1 extra base hit, a double. 2-2 is coming to the plate, lifts it into left center field. That's going to be extra bases. Going to go all the way to the fence. No cut off on the warning track by Truitt. Down to second, a stand-up double. Leading off the sixth inning by LaCroix. Well, he battled one down the right, the left field line, one down the right field line. Both of them fouled, and he hit one into the alley and left center for a double. That's their 5th hit of the ball game. Get a lead double. They had a lead single back in the first. Had a lead single in the 4th. Now a lead double in the 6th. Here's Casey Stone, singled his last time. He has been tough on us. Hits from the left side. That's 3. Here's a ground ball. That'll get through. Base hit between Sheshick and Heaney in the right field. They're going to have runners at first and at third with no out. Single on the ground, Stone. His 2nd hit today. Had 2 hits last night. He runs at first base. LaCroix pushed over to third. Holt got to it in a hurry. Here is Henri Stanley. Aggies ahead 2-0. Clemson's got something working here in the bottom of the 6th inning. Stanley a single back in the 1st. Hit into a double play in the 3rd, 3-6-3. Ward's given up a double in the alley and left center. Now a single on the ground between 1st and 2nd into right field. Sheshick will stand at first base, working on keeping Stone as honest as possible there. Ward works to the plate to Stanley. Swing and a foul tip out of the glove of Schumacher. Khalid Ballouli has just gone down to the Aggie bullpen. 0-1 on Stanley. See if we can avoid the pin here in the 6th inning and let Ward just take care of the men at the plate. Leave those runners right where they are. Ward looks over his shoulder. LaCroix is the base runner, now works over to first base to chase Stone back in.
And the Aggies on the infield are looking for the double play. Not quite as worried about giving up that runner on third as they are trying to get a couple of outs here.
Deep up the middle, straight away in the outfield on Stanley. The pitch to him. Swing and a miss, a strike, 0-2. Blew that one right by him. Stanley has struck out 8 times in postseason play, twice against Aggie pitching. 0-2 on Stanley. Boyd is on deck. He's a switch hitter. Stanley hits from the left side. Boyd will hit from the right. 0-2 coming to the plate. Call strike 3. And Stanley is talking to the home plate umpire, saying that was outside. Caught him looking. Here's Boyd. Boyd hit into a double play back in the 1st inning. 1 out, runners at 1st and at 3rd for Clemson, bottom of the 6th.
This guy is very dangerous, probably the most dangerous hitter they have on their team.
I compare him a lot to Greg Dobbs of last weekend for Long Beach State. Here's Pat Boyd. Ward works. And it's going to be a base hit into right center field. Truitt got over, picked it up. Boyd's trying to go to second base. He will with a double. Run scores, second and third of the runners. It's now 2-1. Boyd delivers a double to right center, his second consecutive hit. Gets the RBI. World of trouble right now. Here's Boltman. He's flying out twice to the outfield. Stone runs at third base. He went first to third on the double. LaCroix has scored. And here is Boltman. Boltman 0 for 2 this weekend against the Aggies. He is now 1 for 9. He hits from the right side. Fly twice. And they are sending Chris Heck down to their bullpen. Here goes Schumacher out to the mound. We might be buying some time here. Well, it starts double, single, then a strikeout looking of Stanley, then a double by Boyd. They get a run. The lead now is 2-1. The Aggies over Clemson in the bottom of the sixth inning with one out. They have runners at second and third. Lindsay is tied at third base. He's on the edge of the grass. We're back deep on the middle infield. Truitt shaded over toward left center as the Aggie center fielder. Holt and Hudson about normal position. I would say that perhaps Hudson somewhat toward the line and left. Even with a bag at first base is Sheshick. So now Ward works. Here's the pitch. Strike on the first offering to Boltman. Boltman has struck out 10 times in postseason, twice against the Aggies. The attendance today is 7,645, 7,645. It's been sold out all three ball games. 2-1 is our score of the Aggies. Fly ball into right field. They will tag Stone at third base. Holt will make the catch. Here's the throw up the line. And he's going to try and tag Stone. He has left the base path. Now he's going back. They tag him. He is out on a throw from the outfield. How about that? He came home. He stopped. Schumacher started chasing him around the plate. He ran behind the plate, then he ran back toward third. He got out of the base path going back toward third. I'm not sure Schumacher ever tagged him. But the umpire at home plate, Rodriguez, will call him out. Boltman flies to right three times to the outfield. Holt's throw came home. And Stone trying to tag at third, trying to score, can't do it. He is out 9-2.